Okay, today we're going to be looking at a task management app that Microsoft has. It's called To Do, and it's designed to be a more modern, flexible take on the task list that you have that's part of Microsoft Outlook right now. This does sync with Microsoft Outlook, so you don't have to do a hard switch. If you want to look at it, it's going to pre-populate with the tasks that you already have, but it's going to give you different ways to organize them. So we're going to use To Do to show you the increased flexibility and depth that it has. And in order to do that, we're going to say that I woke up this morning and I had an epiphany and I decided I wanted to change everything about my life. I'm going to move out west and become a lumberjack. So we're going to use these different features to get that done. And we're going to just increase the complexity as we go so you see these different things. And the first thing that I need to do, so I'm in tasks right now, which is kind of the main list. I'll come over and left click on the plus sign next to add a task. And I'm going to say, I need to start chopping trees. I don't do that very often. And if I just go try to be a lumberjack, it's going to be very painful. I want to saw some logs and I'm going to practice climbing trees. Okay, so I have these three tasks now. And I'm going to have a lot more, but these three kind of belong together. So we're going to create a new list to group these together. And it's an untitled list. We don't want that. So right click on it to rename list. And I'm going to say get in shape. We have our first list here. That's a custom list. We'll go back into task and we're going to drag all three of these into get in shape because that's where they belong. And the get in shape one, what you can also do is you can change the color, change the themes of these. I'm going to make this one, let's say, blue. And the other thing that you can do that's kind of cool, kind of silly, is that you can change the icon. So let's make this one someone flexing their bicep. Okay, and the next thing I want to do is I need to move. I need to move to where there's tree farms, right? So I'm going to say move out west. Capitalize west. I'm going to move out west. That's where the large trees are. So our icon for that, it's going to be this little icon here. It has a tree in it, right? Okay, that looks good. Now we're going to get more in depth. We have this next custom list. As you notice, I started putting things in tasks, but I moved them down. So the tasks is its own list and it's empty now, but we're going to work in move out west. I need to research moving vans. Because I don't know anything about them, but I need to do that soon. So I just left clicked on that and it brought up all of these options on the right hand side. What we're going to do to research a movie van is we need to do that. Let's say next week, we need to get that done. Now you'll notice here, I can add a file as well. So if I left click on add a file, it's going to bring up my file picker. I have no idea what that is. We're going to upload that here. And so you can do a file attachment and you can do more than one. It's waiting for the next one. And then just add some notes to say, I prefer the one with the yellow trucks, whichever one that is. I don't really know. Okay, so when you come back and you look at this task, it's showing you on the screen without drilling into it when the due date is, that it has an attachment, and that there's an associated note with it. So you'll start to see how visually this can be handy that you don't have to click into everything just to kind of get a good overview. We need to pack. And I don't have an exact date that I need to pack by. So instead of doing a due date, I'm just going to have it pop up and remind me. I'd like to get started soon, so I'm going to have it remind me tomorrow. But there is no due date on this, so you can do either or both. Similar to how you could do it in Outlook tasks. And that's all I need to move out west. That's going to get it done. So let's do one more list. We're going to do three of these groups of lists and then we'll see what these other options do at the top. This is going to be apply for jobs. We'll pick a nice icon for this. You know, going to be applying a lot. It's going to take a lot of time. So I'll need some coffee as I do it. So that's of course going to be the icon for that. And let's have this be red because I'm going to be working hard. Maybe be a little tired, be red hot. There we go. Let's add a task. Now, the first thing that I'm going to do is start to look online. But this is a more in-depth one. So we're going to use an ability Well, first we'll give it a due date. We need to start this one soon too, but why do today what you can do tomorrow? So we'll make it start tomorrow. But this one has several sub-steps under it. So I look at this as three layers. The first layer is the list. The second layer is a task. And now there's a third layer called a step. The first step will be choose which online site. All right, there's a million of them. We're just gonna stick to one. Hit enter. It's ready for the next step. I'm going to decide on the keywords. Like, do I type in lumber and let it search for that, or woods, paper? We'll see. And then start applying. Those are the three steps that I need. Now, if we come back here and look at the main task, it says 0 out of 3. If I check one of these off, this is the first time we're going to get to do this. Listen to this. Let's do the top one. Ah, now it says 1 of 3. So if you have several of these listed, you're going to see the status of the steps without drilling into them. Next thing we want to do is subscribe to the paper. Because I'm thinking that lumberjacks don't always go online, right? So they might be looking in the paper for jobs. So we're going to find out which paper we need to subscribe to and do that. And that doesn't need to happen for a while because I'm not even sure where I'm moving. We'll just do that on June 7th. And then the last thing would be if I used a hosted Microsoft email solution, okay, like Outlook or Hotmail, I could flag an email. I can't do that in this account because this is my personal account and I don't use Microsoft for my email. I'll show you a screenshot of another account that has flagged emails. And if you were doing this in a team, someone could give you a task through Microsoft Planner, and those would come in here as well. But we'll just stick in my little free personal account here for now. Now let's head up to the top. You can see that one of these is already populating. So there's a list called Planned. I didn't make this. It comes prepackaged in Microsoft To Do. I'm gonna left click on it. It's showing you an agenda, if you will, of when certain things are due that we just planned. And there's something else a little bit finessed going on here is it's a due date. It's a little icon. I think that's a calendar. But if it's just a reminder, there's an icon of a bell. So it is showing both of them. This doesn't show all of your tasks though. So planned is very helpful, but be careful because if you did not give something a due date, see if I just wanted to get in shape and saw logs, so we were doing this in the beginning before we were doing due dates. It's not on here. Be careful if you want to be a good log sawer, don't just use the plan list, right? The next list that's up here is called important. So if I want to come back to get in shape and I'm going to say sawing logs is important, I need to do that, not on a particular day, but I need to keep that in mind. It'll stay on the list called important. So you can kind of pre-populate this with the things that you just really need to make sure you get done and keep them on your mind throughout the process. And then I save the best for last. I think it's at least the most unique feature. It's called My Day. And the thought of this is that you are in control of your day. You may have all of these things that you need to get done, but today is a new day. This list starts blank every day, and you add things to it that you want to focus on just today. So you see, I just left clicked. You can straight add a task right into here. What you can also do though is go, today I really need to start tree chopping, so I'm going to right click on that, left click on add to my day, and I also need to research moving vans. It's not due for a while, but I need to start. So I'm going to do that today as well. So it puts the My Day indicator here. But what it also does is it fills it into My Day. So I woke up, I got organized, and I said, these two things I really need to do today. I know I need to keep sawing logs on my mind, and this is what I'm doing in the future. And when you're using My Day, there are some smart suggestions. So there's a little bit of AI in here. If you left click on for today, it's thinking that maybe you want to do some of these. We're just going to keep it as, oh snap. Well, we'll pick one more just because I feel like the computer did all this work. We're gonna think about climbing some trees. We're gonna spend the day in the woods. And there you are. You can access a lot of these options just by right clicking. So I've been mostly dragging things around in this tutorial, but you can also get it mostly done by right-clicking. And the mobile apps are going to work in a similar way. They'll have similar options. So it's easier to show things when I can have a mouse that moves around on the screen. Okay, so to learn more about To-Do and to compare it to some other popular organization apps, check out this playlist. Thanks a lot, and don't forget to subscribe if you want to see more videos just like this.